Hello students, I am Aparna Kedari and I am working as an assistant professor in Department of Chemistry, Sarhad College of Art, Commerce and Science. Today we are going to study Chapter 4 from Organic Chemistry, Alkenes. Then first definition of alkenes. Alkenes are unsaturated hydrocarbons having general formula CH2NN. The old name of alkene is olefins, that is carbon-carbon double bonded compounds, or compounds containing carbon-carbon double bonds are called olefin. Therefore, alkenes are the unsaturated hydrocarbons. Unsaturated means there is carbon-carbon double bond is present, and hydrocarbon means they consist of hydrogen and carbon, and they having general formula CnH2n. The presence of carbon-carbon double bond is the characteristic feature of alkene, and it is functional group or reactive site. Alkenes also form homologous series. That is, these are the compounds are differ by CH2 unit. Then isomerism in alkenes. Isomerism means, or isomers means, when two or more compounds having same molecular formula, they differ only in relative orientation of groups, they are called stereoisomers. When stereoisomers are formed due to the restricted rotation about carbon-carbon double bond, the stereoisomers are called geometrical isomers. That is, geometrical isomers arises due to the restricted rotation about carbon-carbon double bond and gives rise to special types of isomerism called geometrical isomerism. When there is carbon-carbon single bond, then it is free to rotate. But when the carbon-carbon double bond is there, then this rotation is restricted, and the isomers arises due to this restricted rotation are called the geometrical isomerism. Then there are two types of geometrical isomerism. First one is the cis, and second one is the trans isomer. In cis isomers means when the same group are on the same side of double bond, it is called cis. And when the same groups are on the opposite side, are called the trans isomer. Here example is cis-2-butene and trans-2-butene. In cis-2-butene, these two hydrogens are on the same side, and here CH3 are on the which are same are on the same side of the double bond. Here the CH3 groups and both these hydrogens are on the opposite side. Therefore, this is trans-2-butene. Then next is the cis isomer. When the cis similar groups or atoms are on the same side of double bond, then the isomer is called cis isomer. And cis isomer is less stable than trans isomer because there is steric hindrance when these two groups are on the same side, and they are less stable than the trans isomer. This is the example cis-2-butene, that is two CH3 group are on the same side of double bond and two hydrogens are on the same side of double bond. Next isomer is trans isomer. When the similar groups or atoms are on the opposite side of double bond, then the isomer is called as the trans isomer. Here these two CH3 groups are on the opposite side of this double bond, therefore it is trans-2-butene. Then next, conditions for geometrical isomerism. First condition is the presence of carbon-carbon double bond, but the presence of this carbon-carbon double bond is not enough for the existence of geometrical isomerism. For example, here 1-butene, isobutylene and the propylene do not show geometrical isomerism because on this carbon there are two similar groups are present. On this doubly bonded carbon, there is same groups of same atoms are present. Therefore, this 1-butene, isobutylene, propylene do not show geometrical isomer even though they contain the carbon-carbon double bond. Then second condition for geometrical isomerism is either of the double bonded carbon should not carry two identical groups, or each olefinic carbon must contain two different atoms or groups. Then here in first example, this doubly bonded carbon bears two different groups, that is A and B. This second carbon is also bears this A and B. And here in second example, therefore it shows the geometrical isomerism. When this AA are on the same side of double bond, it is cis isomer. When they are on the opposite side, then it is called the trans isomer. But in second compound, this double bonded carbon, first carbon bears A and B and second carbon bears two similar groups. Therefore, this compound do not show geometrical isomerism. देन इन नेक्स्ट कंपाउंड दिस ए बी फर्स्ट कार्बन कंटेन ए बी एंड देन सी एंड डी. Then there is another nomenclature is used E and Z so for such type of compounds. Then for example here chlorine are on the opposite side, therefore it is trans 1,2-dichloroethene. And the next one is this when chlorine are on the same side of double bond, it is cis 1,2-dichloroethene. Then in this compound trans 2 pentene, the two hydrogens are on the opposite side of this double bond. Here CH3 is different, ethyl group is different, but these two hydrogens are same, therefore we are determining this cis or trans according to the position of these two hydrogens. Here two hydrogens are on the opposite side of double bond, therefore it is trans 2 butene. Then trans 2 pentene. Here, this two hydrogen atoms are on the same side of the double bond, therefore it is cis-2-pentene. Then in next compound, these two bromine are on the opposite side, these two hydrogens are on opposite side of carbon-carbon double bond, therefore it is trans-isomer and its nomenclature is trans-1,2-dibromoethene. Then second example, bromine-bromine are on the same side of double bond, therefore it is cis-1,2-dibromoethene. Then here transtilbene. In transtilbene, these two pH or phenyl rings are two hydrogens are on the opposite side of double bond. Therefore, it is transtilbene. Then cistilbene, these two phenyl groups are on the same side. It is cistilbene. Then the IUPAC nomenclature of alkenes. Then first rule is select the longest continuous chain of carbon containing the carbon-carbon double bond. The alkene is considered as a derivative of unsaturated alkene having the same number of carbon as the parent in the long chain of alkene, and the suffix ANE of alkene is replaced by the ENE of ENE. Then the carbon chain is numbered in such a way that the numbering starts from the end and which is nearest to the double bond. Then third rule is they indicate the indicate by numbers the presence of the other substituent, and if geometrical isomerism is possible, the prefix cis or trans is used in the nomenclature of alkenes. Then here examples, first two carbon alkene is ethene, there is carbon carbon double bond ethene. Then propene, three carbon alkene is a propene, there is carbon carbon double bond. And one butene onward or butene onward, there is positional isomerism. Therefore, here particularly we are mentioning the position of this double bond. In this case, this the 1, 2, 3, 4. This double bond is at first carbon. Therefore, it is one butene. Then in this compound, 1, 2, 3. This is propene, but the CH3 is present at second carbon as a substituent. Therefore, it is 2-methyl propene. Then in this case 1, 2, 3, 4, that is it is 2-butene. Not pentene, it is butene. Here 1, 2, 3, 4. Here this methyl group is present at the third carbon. 1, 2, 3, 4. And double bond is at first carbon. Therefore, it is 3,3-dimethyl-1-butene. Nomenclature of this compound is 3,3-dimethyl because there are two methyl groups on the third carbon. Therefore, it is 3,3-dimethyl-1-butene. The next example is here 1, 2, 3, 4. It is butene. And it is 1-butene, and the substituent, this phenyl substituent is present at 4th carbon, therefore it is 4-phenyl-1-butene. Then in next compound, it is 1, 2, 3, 4, this is longest chain, 1, 2, 3, 4. Therefore, this bromine is present at 4th carbon as a substituent, and at 2nd carbon, methyl group is present. Therefore, it is 4-bromo. Here, bromo and methyl. Then, therefore, there is according to alphabetic order, this is 4-bromo, two methyl, one butene, because the parent compound is butene, and four is substance, CH is also substance, therefore 4-bromo-methyl-butene. Then in next example, here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So 5, that is, it is pentic. Sorry, here it is 1 pentene. Two, four, four. Here the CH3 group is present at second carbon and third carbon. Sorry, fourth carbon. Therefore, it is the 2-4-4. Sorry, 2-4-4. There are two methyl groups is at fourth carbon. Therefore, it is 2-4-4 trimethyl pentene or pent one pentene or pent one in. Then next is the here chlorine is present, therefore one numbering from this side, because here chlorine is branched, 1, 2, 3, 4. It is butene, that is 2-butene, and chlorine is substance. But here geometry is mentioned, therefore these two CH3 groups are on the same side of double bond, therefore it is cis-2-chloro, because chlorine is that second carbon as a substance, cis-2-chloro-2-butene. Then next example is the trans iodo. Here the hydrogens are same and they are on opposite side, therefore it is trans 1 iodo, because this iodine is at first carbon, 1 iodo propene. Then in next example, it's 4 methyl 3 pentene 1 ol. 1 2 3 4 5 6 sorry 1 2 3 4 5 hexene 1 ol. It is 6 carbon alkane, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Then in this case, this methyl group, actually it is 4 methyl, sorry, not 4 methyl, it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, total 6 carbon atoms, and in this there are two functional group, one is alcohol and one is alkene. Then in this case, this alkene, that is double bond, is at third carbon, therefore it is 3-hexene-1-ol, that is 3-hexene-1-ol. Here E, not hexa, here E, because it is alkene, 3-hexene-1-ol. And in next compound, CH3-CH2-CHBr. It is when this these two hydrogens are on the same side of double bond, therefore it is cis-1-bromo-2-pentene, because so the 1, 2, 3, the pentene is at second carbon. Double bond is at second carbon. The next physical properties. The alkenes are insoluble in polar solvents and such as water, but soluble in non-polar solvents like benzene, ether, carbon tetrachloride, because this is like dissolves like. Alkenes are insoluble in polar solvents because alkenes are non-polar in nature, therefore they are soluble in non-polar solvents and insoluble in water, because water is pure polar. As number of atom increases, the boiling point increases by 20 to 30 degrees Celsius per added carbon atom. This 1-butene has less, 2-pentene has greater boiling point than 1-pentene, 2-butene. Then the density of alkene is lower than the water. As branching increases, the boiling point decreases. Then they very weakly polar, but they alkenes are very weakly polar, but they are polar than alkanes due to the loosely held pi electrons. because carbon, this alkene contain carbon carbon double bond and that is pi bond, and this electron present in this are weakly polar and they are polar than alkenes due to loosely pi electron. The boiling point of alkene and alkenes alkenes and alkenes with the same number of carbon atoms and skeleton nearly the same. Next is the dipole moment. Alkyl substituents are electron donors and therefore they increase the polarity of alkene. Such alkenes have net dipole moment. In this case, this alkene, there is no polarity. Therefore, in ethene, it is its dipole moment is 0 d pi. In this case, the CH3 increase electron density on that on this carbon atom. Therefore, electron donors increase the polarity of alkenes. There is net dipole moment to this side. Therefore, the dipole moment of this propene is 0.35 d pi. And here, this again, there is a net flow of electron to this side because CH3 increase or donate the electron pairs, electrons to this side. Therefore, there is net flow of electron to this side. Therefore, cis-2-butene shows the dipole moment 0.3 d pi. And in case of tri-2-butene, the dipole moment is dipole due to this CH3 is exactly cancelled by the second CH3, and therefore trans isomer will have zero dipole moment. In case of cis isomer, they do not cancel out with each other and it will show 0.3 dipole moment. And then at a room temperature, C2 to C4 alkene are gases, C5 to C18 alkenes are liquids, and above C18 are onwards are solids. Then cis isomer has lower symmetry in structure than the trans isomer. The cis isomer therefore does not fit in the crystal lattice, and therefore cis isomer have lower melting point and trans alkenes have higher melting point. Then here cis 1 to dichlorobenzene, here dipole moment is 1.85 d pi. Boiling point is 60 degrees Celsius and melting point is minus 80 degrees Celsius. In second example, it is trans isomer. It is trans 1 to dichloroethene. Dipole moment is 0 d pi. Boiling point and melting point is minus 50 degrees Celsius. And boiling point is 48 degrees Celsius. Next, cis isomer. Dipole is greater, that is 1.15 d pi. Therefore, boiling point is also higher, 110 degrees Celsius, and melting point is minus 53 degrees Celsius. In trans isomer, there is zero dipole because the dipole caused by CBr bond. One CBr bond is cancelled out by second CBr bond. Therefore, zero dipole, and melting point is minus 6 degrees Celsius. This is all about introduction of alkene physical properties and nomenclature of alkenes.